Hi again, welcome to another episode of Under Control, the show just for Visual Studio subscription administrators. I am your host, Xavier Morera, and thanks to everyone for the great feedback on our first episode. If you missed that one, we'll link to it for our YouTube watchers in the description below. For this episode, I thought I'd focus on some of the common questions that we receive and what to do about them. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Let's kick it off with our first question. My organization recently renewed our agreement. I still have access to the admin portal, but all I see is that the agreement is expired. How do I refresh it? This can be answered in a number of ways because we need to understand why the portal isn't reflecting the updated information. For example, if your organization has Visual Studio subscriptions set up as part of a volume licensing agreement, it depends what part of the renewal process has been completed. Usually, a renewal process will start with a primary contact for the agreement, and they will engage with a reseller for the processing of the renewal. As a side note, the primary contact for an agreement does start out as a super admin, but may have removed themselves after adding other admins and super admins. Anyway, the primary contact works through the renewal with the reseller, and the reseller completes all of the updates, which then feeds into the volume licensing portal before feeding into the Visual Studio subscriptions portal. Let me show you. If your company renewed the existing agreement and the agreement number is unchanged, you will see a new agreement end date, and all of your subscriptions will show an updated expiration date. You can view the information about your agreement by selecting the agreement details here on the left. If your company renewed their agreement, but you're still seeing expired agreement information, there are a couple of possible causes. The first is that rather than renewing the existing agreement, your organization may have set up a new agreement under the master agreement, like this. If that's the case, you should be able to view the new agreement by selecting the agreement picker and selecting the new agreement. If you click the drop-down on the agreement picker and don't see any new agreements listed, it may be because you aren't listed as an admin on the new agreement. If that's the case, you'll need to contact a super admin to be granted admin permissions to the new agreement number. You can see the super admins by going back to the agreement details and checking the names at the bottom under super admins. It's hard to know without further visibility if that's the reason or if it's something else. Other reasons could be that it's still somewhere along the timeline for processing. So if you need to wait before hearing back from a super admin, it wouldn't hurt to refresh the portal and check back in that time. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Our company is going to be changing email domains. What do I need to do in order to make sure that my and the other admin's access isn't affected by the change? And what about subscribers' access? This is a great question, and there's a lot to unpack here. To start, let me give you an overview, and then we'll dive into the details. I will say we do hear quite often from admins after their emails have changed, and that usually requires a call to support. So it's great that you're asking this ahead of time. The ideal way to tackle an email domain change is to proactively add the new email addresses for all admins, including yourself. As soon as your team has access to their new email accounts, they'll want to go in and find their Visual Studio subscription admin welcome email. From that email, they'll follow the link to take them to the admin portal. If they haven't already created a Visual Studio profile with the new email address, they'll be prompted to do so. It's very simple and isn't strictly for Visual Studio subscriptions, but it is for other Microsoft developer tools and services, including Azure DevOps, Visual Studio, Visual Studio subscriptions, and more. After completing their Visual Studio profile, they should have access to the Manage portal, and it should look just as with their original email address. I know that was a lot, so let's take a look together at what this process looks like. Let me show you. All of this first part of adding admins will need to be done as a super admin. If you aren't a super admin, you can reach out to your super admin for support. Again, you can see the super admins by going back to the agreement details and checking the names at the bottom under super admins. So assuming you're a super admin, let's press on. I'm starting out here on the Manage Administrators tab, and I'm going to add myself first. So I'm going to click on Add, and now I'm going to add myself, Xavier Morera, and Xavier add tailwindtradersdev.onmicrosoft.com. Perfect. I'll make sure to check the box to make myself a super admin. So once I'm using my new email, I can also add or update all of the other admins' logins, and then I'll click on add. As expected, I've got this nice yellow reminder box up here pointing out that this administrator isn't in the current tenant or directory. I'd like to take this opportunity for anyone who hasn't heard me mention this before. This is not an error. It's just a message to double check for accuracy. Okay, yes, I know if this was intentional, please ignore and continue. Yes, thank you. I'll do that. Now, let me show you. My email account has gone live, so I need to jump into my inbox. Hopefully, I'll find my welcome email, and indeed, it's right there. But what if the email is not there? Maybe it went out before the account was live. Well, that's not a problem. I'll simply go to the admin portal and click on this dot right here and select resend. It will ask us if we're sure, and I just need to click on confirm. Since I already have the email, this is not necessary. Okay, so now let's go see in my Outlook. I've got my welcome email, as would all of the other admins if I had added them already. So let's confirm now that we can access the admin portal. Down here, I'll click the link to assign and manage subscriptions. A few more details are needed. Since this is the first time that I'm accessing with my new email address, I just need to take a few seconds to create my Visual Studio profile. It's super easy. All I need to enter here is my name, my email, and my country. And now I can move on into the Manage portal. I won't need to create that Visual Studio profile again now that I've done this with a new email address. Now that I've been able to successfully access the Manage portal with the new email address, I can remove my old user with the old email address. The same goes for other admins, and you can do that easily by clicking again on the dots in the Manage Administrators tab on my user. Here I am, Xavier. I just need to click on Delete and confirm when ready. But I won't do that yet, as I am not done. Now, the process for subscribers is a bit different. For the subscribers, once their new email accounts are active, you can just go and edit their email addresses to reflect the new ones. You won't want to take the same proactive approach as we discussed with the admins, because while you can have any number of admins, your number of subscriptions, of course, are limited. The good news is that you don't need to update or add each subscriber individually as with the admins. We'll start by clicking over to the Manage Subscribers tab. And just as a reminder, when you switch between Manage Administrators and Manage Subscribers, you'll want to always double check on the agreement picker to make sure that you're looking at the right agreement number. The portal won't by default show the same agreement on both pages. So if you selected a specific agreement on your Administrators tab, it's always best practice to check the selected agreement on your Manage Subscribers tab when you switch over. Let me show you. All we need to do is to click on Bulk Edit, and then the dialog box pops up. So we'll need to do step one, which is to export the Excel. I'll click that, and my Excel opens, showing the details for all of my current subscribers. Let me maximize, enable editing, and select the correct tab. Now, when doing this, I will usually export this in advance and use it to make sure I've gathered all of the correct new email addresses for everyone. So it's right here. I'm going to copy, and I'm going to paste right here. And it's ready. Now is a great time if you need to make any other changes as well. That's all I need to do right now, so I will save this file to my downloads so it's easy to find. And then I'll come back here to the portal and click Browse to upload. So let me do this. I come back here, click on Browse, Downloads, I upload, and then I'll select OK. Now all of our email addresses have been updated. One call out here. You'll see that I have one Azure Active Directory group with all the subscriptions assigned. This is a great feature that, as an administrator, I really love. When our org switches over, our IT team is doing all of this backend work of updating everyone's account, assuming they update everyone's email correctly in our Azure Active Directory, because I have the Azure AD group assigned here, I won't have to do anything to update this. If you wanted to check, you can view the subscribers in the Azure AD group. This is what I just did by clicking on View Subscribers. Now, if this change had happened, all of the email addresses would have been updated with the new ones by someone from our Azure AD admin team. Another item to keep in mind when you change the subscribers' email addresses, this will change the login for the portal, but for the majority of their benefits, if they've already activated the benefit with their old email address as a login, then that email will remain their login. Now, I did mention that I was describing the ideal way, so I want to talk about what to do in the case that you're not doing this whole process proactively. In that case, the email addresses have already changed and you don't have access to the portal. You'll need to reach out to support so they can grant you access. When you call, you'll need to be able to authenticate the account, which means you'll want to be ready to provide them with your agreement details. Okay, let's see how many other questions we have here. I'm brand new to this, and it's all a lot of information. I'm looking to understand the difference between an admin and a super admin. How do I know which one to pick? Hey, thanks for asking this. I know it can be a lot at first, but I'm here to help. So for admin versus super admin, the differences are pretty simple. Really, an admin can only add subscribers, while a super admin can add subscribers, other administrators, and also set the agreement level preferences. Here you can see in the admin portal, let me click on the gear icon. Only super admins will have this. Here you can manage the agreement level preferences, default subscription level, default communication preferences, default setting for allowing external subscribers, and also for allowing downloads and product keys. Something I skipped over at the top, you'll see there's a contact email address. The subscribers in their subscription portal have a button that says, Contact my admin, and they can send the message that will arrive via email. This field right here for contact email address is where communications go when a subscriber uses that function. If it's left blank, the communications will go to all admins. And I wouldn't say that default preferences would likely change much after they're set, but as far as admin versus super admin, it's always good to have at least two super admins. In case one leaves or isn't available, there's another one to help admins. If you're interested in more details around the agreement preferences, I did spend a little bit more time talking about these in our last episode. We'll pop up a link here tonight or tomorrow after we post this, if you want to click that to go watch our previous episode. Okay, what else do we have here? Hey Xavier, we purchased a new agreement recently, but when I look at the new agreement in my admin portal, the subscriber list is blank and all of our subscribers are still on the old agreement. How do I get them transferred over? Hey, thanks for the question. I'll give you two answers to this. One option for moving subscribers over to new agreements is when the new agreement is purchased. The reseller has the option to select to transfer your subscribers. This is on the reseller's side, and hopefully they would ask about this. But something to keep in mind and mention if you have access or if you're involved in this transaction. If your reseller did select this, it can take a day or two, maybe even three after you set up the new agreement, that you'll see the subscribers update over. Now, I'll assume that in the case of your question, that the reseller did not make that selection, so we'll need to do it manually. Let me walk you through what this looks like. So I'm here on the Manage Subscribers tab, and first thing we want to make sure is that we've selected the old agreement in the Agreement Picker. Next, we'll want to export the list of current subscribers, like this. Okay. Now I'll jump over to my new agreement, this one. So now I'm going to select Add and Bulk Add. This gives me the dialog box where I can export the Bulk Add template. I'll click on Download, and now I just need to open both files. Now let me put them side by side. I'll click on Enable Editing in both of them and select the correct tab. Perfect. Now I'm going to copy over the information. I'll start with the subscriber. There you go. Now the signing email. Now the signing email. Okay, next the country. Okay, then the language. Okay. moving forward with the subscription level. Then the download and product keys. Then the download product keys. There are no references. And there's only one notification email. This one right here. One note is that we don't want to copy over the subscription goods because they will get all new goods with the new agreement and all of their benefits will be refreshed. So they will have a refreshed tech support incidents available to them, a fresh 3 or 6 months of Pluralsight, a new LinkedIn premium account, a new Azure DevOps plan, everything new. It would be good also to warn your subscribers that this process of getting new subscriptions will be happening so they have a chance to save and transfer any Azure resources that they wish to continue working within their new subscriptions DevOps instance. Okay, but we still need to upload all of the subscribers. So I'm going to save this spreadsheet. Let me just close it. And then I'll go back to the portal. In here, I'm going to select Browse. Select the Excel spreadsheet and click on OK. Now, everyone who I just uploaded will get a welcome email for their new subscription. It would be good to confirm that everyone has access to their new subscription before removing them from the old subscription. And yes, it is recommended to remove them from the old subscription just to prevent any confusion should they receive any emails pertaining to the expired subscription. And that's it for today. I'm here to help you. This is our hub, and you're welcome here anytime. Drop us a note in the comments. We'd love to answer your questions or hear about something you'd like to see explained in a future episode. I'm Xavier, and I'm helping you keep things under control.